highest bidder and whoever pays them the most. In terms of its social impact, I just want to touch upon what I think are currently the three genres of Indian cinema, which is becoming accepted terminology in India now: the real, the surreal, and the unreal. The black and white that you see there is what represents reality cinema. And that is a picture out of a film called Pathar Panchali by a filmmaker called Satyajit Ray, who won the Lifetime Achievement Award some years ago at the Oscars. The man in blue is the greatest superstar of India. And you can see why. He has the native look. He doesn't look socially disconnected in terms of his look. He represents the guy next door. And yet you can see from his body language that he can easily beat up 100 guys at a time. That's very important for the fantasy of the average Indian. The third one that you see, it's called Savariya. It's a film that was released this year and the greatest box office flop of the year. And it was the great entry point of Sony Pictures into India. And Sony Pictures is having a tough time cleaning up its own mess right now in India. And I think a lot of Indian producers are quite delighted that this film didn't do well, because the American players are coming into India not to do anything different, but to actually eat into the market share of what is already Bollywood cinema. So there has been some insecurity in India about what the big global players would come and do in terms of penetrating their markets. But this film has actually done very badly, although no film has got the kind of publicity that it has. Cultural impact. I just want to go through this very quickly. Mainstream formula films are based on their own perceptions of westernization in every aspect of filmmaking. So it's the great American dream of that particular director who thinks that his audience has that same great American dream. So it is an individual perception of what the great American dream is. The cinema advertising nexus promotes not just products, but lifestyles, where culture specificities and nuances are actually threatened. Indian films have a tangible impact on youth. The cinema advertising nexus deliberately develop and merchandise film trends and styles from hair clips to retro wardrobes. So the making of a film is not just about the film. I mean, for my own film, I must tell you a quick, funny story, where we hired some interesting imitation jewelry because it was a film about a dancer. And we got some really hefty offers for an auction. And we had to sadly tell them that they were not authentic pieces. But we probably could have, you know, in retrospect, we should have had the authentic jewelry and we could have gone for an auction because it would have sold at a premium, because we got the maximum number of national awards for last year. The new trend of commercial films fashioned in culturally alien settings aims to reach global urban audiences and the diaspora. However, it was a filmmaker rooted in his own culture who won the Lifetime Achievement Award at the Oscars. So I think there's a lot of confusion in India and lack of clarity about what international audiences really want from India. I don't think anybody has done a serious study on that. Because we have been told, and there have been many newspaper reports, that a typical Bollywood commercial film and the film that I made have both done well abroad. So we don't really know what audiences want. In terms of economics, more than 50% of the Indian TV industry's revenue is derived from film-based programs. The top three revenue earners of all channels are film-based programs. This is important. Film stars are used as protagonists for the growing industries of animation, gaming, and new media comics. So even there, you need film stars or the popular characters that they've represented. Live events and film award functions are revenue earners, since the branded stars participate, even though the quality of the event is often compromised. Because a lot of the film stars are not really dancers and singers, but they have to do the dancing and singing on stage too, you know? And that compromises the quality of the program. Here we come. You have to give me feedback on this. Bollywood, as the mainstream face of India, is considered problematic in India, because Bollywood does not represent even 1% of Indian cultural diversity and the richness of Indian culture. The non-resident Indian filmmakers are also perceived as representing Indian cinema, which is very important. The filmmakers like Deepa Mehta, Meera Nair, and Hollywood has used them as entry points to introducing Indian cinema to the world. The international film festivals are probably the only platforms that do some kind of justice to representing the diversity of Indian cinema and the pluralism of Indian cinema. I just want to quickly, one more minute. Since the TV boom, film stars are being shipped in to please the diaspora abroad. There's an Indian actor called Shilpa Shetty who participated in The Big Brother, a very popular TV program in the UK. And she's become some kind of a household name in England, much more than she is in India right now. She doesn't really have too many film offers in India, but she, I think, is sitting on many plum offers which are out of the UK. So this is very interesting. Indo-American and Indo-European productions are now underway. And it's interesting that the Indo-American productions are hardcore Bollywood commercial styled, while the latter are very, very postmodern art films that are being produced. So the nuanced Indian cinema is getting lost somewhere between these two. Indian cinema is a powerful vehicle for the diaspora to stay connected with its roots that I've talked to you about. This will make Kala very happy.